Okay.
This is a take two because I'm trying to get my mind straight.
And I'm not helping giving her war flashbacks over annoying characters from Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends.
Okay, so we saw If. And it's it really hits home. The point of the film is, you know, teaches, you know, family, don't grow up too fast. In my household, I wasn't really allowed to express things that were quote-unquote childish.
And this movie is saying that that's dumb, so let's focus on the movie.
I'm just explaining why it hits home. That being said, so the movie is Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends with extra less steps. Irritating characters.
Coco is great and Cheese is the best. No. You can go fuck yourself.
No. Fight me in the comments. Foster's Home is the reason I stopped watching Cartoon Network. Anyway.
So
the plot of the film revolves around a girl named Elizabeth. And she has, you know, she has a wild imagination, but within the first 5 minutes of the movie, you are hit right in the feel holes.
Why you gotta say it like that?
And her mom, you know, while she's being a kid, goes through cancer and passes away. So in her mind, she's not allowed to have fun anymore. Her mom's gone, so she's gotta grow up. Is her mindset.
And her dad's trying to just keep her like, you're like 12, lighten up a little, basically.
Her dad is constantly trying to remind her to just have fun with life. And then he gets hit with needing heart surgery.
This kid has a terrible, terrible luck in the parental health department.
And that father's played by John Krasinski, who is the writer and director.
Okay, so she was 3 and 5 in the flashbacks, apparently, so it's been like 7 years.
Yeah, okay. So, you know, she's 12 now. And she slowly starts seeing ifs. Imaginary friends. we've just been having an Emily Blunt today, haven't
apparently,
we?
But there is a lot of big names in the voices. George Clooney was the spaceman, Awkwafina was Bubble, Bradley Cooper was Ice.
Matt Damon was the flower.
Bill Hader was the banana, of course. Keegan-Michael Key was the slime.
Of course Blake Lively was in it.
Well, yeah, Ryan's gonna cast his spouse, like... The wife gets in the movie. That's what happens.
So... Ew, Amy Schumer. That's why... No, that's why the gummy bear was annoying.
The gummy bear is annoying because it's a gummy bear. Alright, Aurora, I love you, but stop sending me your capstone. I'm not reading 47 pages of shit I don't understand.
Okay, so, the basic plot, we're getting distracted, and, you know, my girlfriend's picked the worst time to start blowing up the chat. But, basically, she starts seeing ifs, and, you know, she learns that imaginary friends, once their child outgrows them, they basically start to disappear. And in the process of it, she tries to basically become Frankie from Fosters.
Yeah, she's trying to play matchmaker and get the kids matched up with
new kids.
Yeah, get imaginary friends matched up with new kids, but realizes, no, what she's actually going to do is help them find their old kids, because their old kids still need them.
So it's the basic concept of hold on to your childhood and, you know,
you don't have to put things away just because you grew up.
Yeah. Kind of like, you know, the whole Peter Pan concept of not everyone has to grow up. You don't have to be what is considered childish by society is not always childish. Mm. And I wasn't expecting to get hit in the heart.
Yeah.
Just reminds of my own imaginary friend, which I may or may not have gotten tattooed.
My imaginary friend was a cat, and I got a very fat, asshole-ish cat now, so
Princess,
I just adopted mine.
Princess Turtle. But shout out to Kara for that one.
Yeah, if anyone is in our area and needs tattoos, hit us up. We know an artist.
But yeah, so it's basically, you know, coming of age story of be who you are and don't try to be who you aren't.
Hmm. It's a coming of age story that allows you to still be a child.
Yeah.
The plot is, it's a little bit loose. It's a little bit
disjointed,
but it's a family movie with, you know, funny imaginary friends, and it puts more emphasis on not like the spectacle per se, but just the visuals, which that's fine. As I said in our earlier review today, don't judge a movie for something it's not trying to do.
Yeah.
So this movie was trying to be a cute story with cute visuals and funny characters and a good message, and it did that.
I honestly,
and the ending sequence was just so sweet, and I was tearing up by that point.
I'm not gonna lie, I was in tears.
She lost it like 10 minutes from the end. I held out until the very ending sequence.
It's a heartstring moment. I don't want to, you know, spoil that specific thing.
Yeah.
But
the ending was good, though, and it didn't do the cop-out that I was afraid it might.
What do you mean?
The cop-out of, oh, it was all a dream, none of it's real, and like, that fucking bullshit that a lot of kids' movies do.
Oh, where, you know, nothing was ever real, but
yeah, it was all in your imagination, but that doesn't make it any less real. Fuck you, this is a movie, make it more real than that.
Right?
Like, it's what you're here for.
Like, the whole point is imagination is the source of everything, so it's one of those movies, it's hard to really say anything without spoiling this one, and I feel like this one is, like, you don't get a lot of what is really going on in the movie from the trailers, so this is one of those that you try to keep it spoiler free, because
yeah, just go see it, it's really cute.
It's cutesy. Like the other movie we saw today, I don't think it's perfect, but
movies really are
not bad.
It was cute. If you've got kids, you can take them to see it. If you don't have kids, you'll probably still like it yourself.
I did enjoy this one more than Fall Guy.
I liked Fall Guy more, but I like the action sequences.
Yeah. So, I say go see it. Ryan Reynolds is always good.
I love Ryan Reynolds. He's always a win.
And I really do love Ryan's character.
Yeah.
You could tell he was trying really hard not to say anything about
what ended up being the case, yeah.
Yeah.
It's
small spoilers since we're already at that
point. No, don't spoil anything. Especially because if they're anything like me, they're going to catch it immediately. Like, it's kind of a spoiler, but also if you're looking for it and you kind of have an idea of where this movie could be going, within the first half hour or so, you'll know what his character's deal is.
If you pay attention to the small context clues.
Yeah, small details. I was about to mention another movie where the same kind of context gives it away, but that would give away too much, so I won't mention the name of the other movie.
So with that being said, I personally, I think this would, a 7 for me.
I would say 7.5, 8 for me.
That being said, if you like this video, hit the like button, hit that subscribe button. Wrong outro, but whatever. I'm tired.
We'll go get you a nap. It's fine.
You're a nap. Thanks for watching.